I'm Andy Paul. I'm the public relations representative for Georgia EMC. So we are representing the 41 electric membership cooperatives across our state. And so our job is to provide safe, reliable, and affordable power to rural areas and urban areas all across the state of Georgia. We're here at the Electric Cooperative Training Center, which has this training substation, which allows our line workers and linemen to learn about all of the different safety aspects when it comes to dealing with electricity. Electricity is a form of energy resulting from the flow of electrons. Electrons are negatively charged particles that are found in atoms. You can think of atoms as the building blocks of matter, and they are found in everything. Electricity happens when electrons get bumped from one atom to another. We encounter electricity constantly. Electricity exists naturally, even in our own bodies, and it can be harnessed and generated for everyday use. There are two types of electricity, static electricity and current electricity. Static electricity is caused by friction when two items or things rub up against each other and creates the potential for a discharge of electron. Now, this can happen on a really cold morning when we're walking across the carpet and creating that friction, or it can be as huge as two clouds colliding together to create lightning. In 1832, a man named Michael Faraday discovered that electrical charges could be made when an electrical conductor was moved in a magnetic field. This movement resulted in an electrical current. This discovery allowed us to take the electricity that we knew was there, but allowed us to harness it. We're able to create electricity in a lot of different areas and generate that energy through different examples of traditional resources like natural gas, coal, and even nuclear energy. There's also renewable resources like solar and wind power. Now, how that different? Static electricity is like a giant buildup, and so this energy is being stored and prepared for one big release. That's not what we're wanting in our homes. We don't want our homes to have one giant release of electricity and our lights to cut off. That's why we have to use traditional generation methods so that we can have the lights glowing until we decide to cut them off. The heart of the power plant are these turbines. These turbines rotate giant coils of wire between these two magnets, which generates what engineers call electromagnetic induction, which creates electricity. You'll see the same basic elements no matter what power generation plant you go to. Conductors are what allow us to send electricity from our generation plants to our homes. So we have to have a high quality conductor to get that electricity. But a conductor is a material that's really good at transmitting electrons. So we think about metal, copper. An insulator is a material that is not good at conducting electrons. Rubber and glass are two examples of these, which is why when you see linemen working around your house, they have on these giant rubber gloves to make sure that they can remain safe as they're delivering electricity to your home. When electricity is generated, it's transported across these giant electrical lines, these giant wire structures that you're probably seeing as you're driving down the road, in the tens of hundreds of thousands of volts. And then it travels to a substation where it can be brought to typically less than 10,000 volts. From that substation, that's where the power is directed to the transformers right outside of your home and then into your home that power your appliances. So that same electricity that starts at the power plant is the same electricity that powers your home. Electricity from a power plant is fed into the electric grid, which is a series of wires and connectors that make up this giant entire circuit, which brings power to your homes. The word circuit comes from the word circle, which means that the electrons have to flow in a complete circle all the way back to the source. And so we add outlets, motors, and switches along that circuit so that we can harness the energy. Now we can also use switches to create a smaller circuit within there so we can use that energy in our homes. Those switches allow us to cut on lamps and other electrical appliances. And when you see those everyday appliances like a lamp, you'll notice that it has a paired wire with prongs that allows the electrons to flow in one complete circuit. So when we turn a switch off, we're disconnecting that circuit, which is why the light's cut off. We are completing that circle when we turn a switch on. Life without electricity would look a whole lot different. Electricity provides convenience when it comes to heating up our food, heating our homes, or providing us with entertainment. I can't think of anybody that wants to sit at their dinner table powered by an oil lamp doing their homework. But electricity allows us the convenience for everyday life and provides an opportunity for safe and thriving communities.